just a big, fat panda.
I'm not a big, fat panda. I'm the big, fat panda. Skadoosh.
American Horror Story tonight. Yes.
That's awesome, but can we get the groceries in first? We have plenty of time till tonight.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah. Yeah. Honey, I'm gonna go open the door, okay?
Okay.
Michael Myers. He just wants the candy.
What?
He just wants the candy.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. That was awkward. That was awkward.
I don't know what this is.
It's okay. It's okay. Did you really think Fat Michael Myers was going to catch you? He's not going to.
Hello and welcome to Big Fat Panda Show number 16. I have to thank Sherry Jones and Jason Noel for their participation in that. And Jason's name being Jason, we thought this could happen.
Jason! Jason! Not that, Jason. Seriously?
My exclusive sponsor, David's Vacation Club Rentals at DVCRentals.com. David and his whole family and some employees were out here this month, and that's one of the things that I wanted to touch on is how the whole company really is a family. And they don't tell me to say this, I just come up with this stuff, but it's true. People come up to me and say, John, do you really believe in this company? And if I didn't believe in them, I could not have them as a sponsor. So I really do believe in the company. They are very close-knit. I'm very proud to be a part of them. I'll cover that more later, because they took us to a wonderful dinner and to the top of the Contemporary to see the finale of Halloween. On my first Disney cruise. It was the older ship that had not been refurbished. I was told if you're going to start somewhere, that's okay to start there. I really had a wonderful time. The cabin, the room itself is really not bad. The bathroom scared the heck out of me. I was like, wow, that shower curtain fought with me a lot. But once you get over that, beautiful time. Not, you know, we went without kids, and I was shocked with how many kids I did not see. There were so many adult-only areas that were just fantastic. Best part of the cruise for me was seeing the private island Castaway Key. It's spelled Castaway K, but quickly I started to hear everybody say Castaway Key. Take a look at this beautiful island. just incredible. I had a hard time the first night. I looked down and there's like stats on the TV that tell you, you know, the water depth is 700 feet. And I'm like, how am I going to go to sleep above the ocean? There's sharks and octopuses and stuff living under there. It just freaked me out, but I obviously got through it. They're also celebrating holidays now on the ship. So one of the things they did was Halloween on the high seas, where they have this spooky Halloween tree. And over the course of the cruise, it grows. It sprouts pumpkins and things. There are shows that go along with it. Here's a little clip of the show that goes along with it. All of these videos can be found on BigFatPanda.com. Dance Halloween costume party, and it's a big show with the characters in the lobby. This guy Andy, he's not the cruise director, I think he's the entertainment director. What energy this guy's got. Availability of food is just bonkers. I mean, free 24-hour room service, and please just go on a Disney cruise. It's fantastic. Back home, something happened at the Haunted Mansion that should have happened back in 1971. They opened up a Haunted Mansion merchandise store. It's called Memento Mori, which I'm told roughly translates to Remember Death. Now, the shop is not big, but there's so many little things crammed into it. And the items, the merchandise, a lot of it is new, never seen before, Haunted Mansion merchandise. Everybody I've spoken with is scared of going broke in there, including myself. The best thing, for $19.95, they take a picture of you, and then they put some spirit thing over it, and it's lenticular as you turn it. Take a peek of the inside of the store and me getting my ghost spirit photo.
Keep going left and right, that's awesome.
Every couple of days?
It's a long time now. Oh, Bill!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's going to serve as our merchandise segment this month, because Corinne Anderson from Disney Lifestylers and Disney Merchandise Spies is a little bit under the weather, but she'll be back. So remember The Little Mermaid, The Princess and the Frog, and Aladdin? They were produced and directed by Ron Clements and John Musker, the same team that's producing the next Disney animated tale. This one's called Mona, M-O-A-N-A. Mona is a South Pacific legend. Action-packed sea adventure, I believe. They say that it's going to take place in, I guess it's like a Hawaii, because there's a demigod in it named Maui. In any event, it was slated for 2018. It will be out now in 2016. I'm really excited about this. It looks pretty nice. You see these two people here? The guy is Chris Reed from V24 Radio, good friend of mine, lives in Canada. That is Heather, his now fiance. They just came down here and they got engaged. Congratulations to Chris and Heather. Last month I talked about some changes going on at Disney. Well, it looks like there's a lot more in store, especially over at Disney's Hollywood Studios, which there is a rumor they may be getting a name change. Now people go, oh my God, rumors, we don't talk about rumors. As long as I'm telling you it's a rumor, why can't we discuss it? Especially one that I think will come true. They're saying that the name will change to Disney's Hollywood Adventure. Rumor, not true, you know, not completely true right now. Which makes sense because it's less of a studio, so it's no longer a working studio. The hat, the sorcerer's hat, at the end of Hollywood Boulevard is going away. People freak out. It's the icon! How can they get rid of the icon? If you're a little bit older like me, that's not the icon. The icon at the end of Hollywood Boulevard was always the Grumman's Chinese Theater. So I think, you know, the hat was built, I think, in 2001 for Walt's birthday to celebrate his 100th birthday. It was only planned to be there for a year, maybe a year and a half. So it's overstayed its welcome. It's a pin shop. I do hope they relocate it outside maybe before you get in, before the bag check area. There's plenty of room there. And all the other changes are, you know, Indiana Jones is supposed to be going away. Some of these are rumors, some of these are fact. There's a lot of stuff going on with Pixar, that whole area, possible Star Wars land. It just looks like that park is going to get a complete overhaul. Now, the Magic Kingdom got a new parade. I hate to say it's a parade because, to me, the 3 o'clock parade, Festival of Fantasy, is amazing, and that's a parade. I guess these are like parade appetizers. The Move It, Shake It, Celebrate It Street Party has now become the Move It, Shake It, Dance and Play It Street Party. Soon to be the Spin It, Drop It, Flop It, and Throw It in the Garbage. I don't understand the music to it. I don't like the whole thing. It just, I guess the Festival of Fantasy spoils me, but it is new. I got a quick glimpse of it. The floats are pretty much the same with these big TVs on them, and apparently you vote for the song you want at the end. By November, I'll have a full video of it and have the full scoop. Here's just a quick glimpse. They added Stitch and Phineas and Ferb to the floats as well. So I filmed my latest resort video for David's Vacation Club Rentals. On his channel, youtube.com/DVCRequest, you can find room tours and resort tours. This last one was the Beach Club. And you know, I've stayed there in the room, but I didn't have a lot of time to look at the resort. I really was impressed with the resort itself, much more than the room. I mean, the pool area, the restaurants, the whole beach area there with the ship, with the pirate ship, it was just, it's gorgeous. Surely, Disney Springs is starting to take shape. In a place called The Landing, Morimoto, one of the Iron Chefs, will be opening a two-story restaurant. It's his first. It looks like a Pan-Asian type of a restaurant. Dim sum, Peking duck carving. It just looks beautiful. I'm very excited to bring this new concept to Disney, something I've always dreamed of, said Chef Morimoto. It's a wonderful chance to share some of my favorite foods from across the Asian continent. Another upscale waterfront dining experience will be the Boathouse. There's supposed to be live music, guided boat tours. I'm not sure how that fits in with dinner, but it seems to be an interactive, themed dinner experience. I just love that these are all different. You know, it's not McDonald's on Pleasure Island. So I have something for you to marvel at, pun intended. Marvel gave their schedule for like the next 1,000 years of movies. I mean, it's really up until like 2017. But listen to this lineup. We've got May 2015, Avengers Age of Ultron. July 2015, Ant-Man. May 2016, Captain America Civil War. November 2016, Doctor Strange. May 2017, Guardians of the Galaxy 2. Can't wait. July 2017, Thor Ragnarok. I'm just reading this. November 2017, Black Panther. May 2018, Avengers Infinity War Part 1. July 2018, Captain Marvel. November 2018, Inhumans. And May 2019, Avengers Infinity War Part 2. My good friend Sean Duffy from Enchanted Tiki Podcast was in New York at the Comic Con, and he took a video of people doing cosplay, and most of it's Disney. It was really interesting, and it's definitely worth showing you a few minutes of. Take a look at these crazy. And the prize for this month is a $10 Disney gift card, along with a Keith Lapinig pin, I Like Warm Hugs. Keith Lapinig is going to be our guest in December, and boy, do we have a prize package of pins for you. So we're just touching on that right now for this prize. In order to be in the running for the prize, simply make sure you're subscribed to BigFatPanda.com and like this video. Give it a nice thumbs up for me and leave any comments you want on the video. You can say anything. I read them all and I love to respond. This is a very special show because we have a very special guest. Of course, all of my guests are special, but this guest is Bob Jackson, whose alter ego is Yeehaw Bob, sort of like a clown entertainment type guy. This definitely goes down in history as the oddest interview I've ever conducted. I think the part of me thought that I was going to get Bob Jackson, but be careful what you wish for. I asked for an interview with Yeehaw Bob, and that's exactly what I got. It's the first interview that I didn't have to edit 1 second out of. I hope you enjoy it as much as I did. So we look presentable?
Absolutely.
Okay. And as promised, I have here a bundle of energy that is Yeehaw Bob. Yeah, Yeehaw Bob is here in my house. I didn't expect it. And he's leaving. He left the building. And I am going to give him the panda hug if he lets me.
Oh, yeah! Friends out there on the BigFatPanda.com show. Yahoo! Oh! Okay, right. Let's get started with the show.
I have cats. Right. That will give me your hand a hug. Right. I have cats that just thought that something bad just happened.
Yeah, no. We ain't scared.
I have to tell you.
Yeah, keep going.
Thank you so much for coming.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Thank you for letting me come.
I know you have a very busy schedule.
Oh, busy guy. Busy.
You are busy. So, I know you from Port Orleans Star.
Port Orleans Riverside. 17 years on that little stage.
Do you have an actual sense of how popular you actually are there to those people?
I'm just go in there every night and have the most fun of all. That's okay. All I want to do.
Well, let me tell you, though, you're a big deal there.
Oh,
When you pull up to the toll booth, yeah. And you say to the guy, "Hi, I'm trying to find out if," and he goes, "Yeah, if Yeehaw Bob was working tonight, yeah, he's here on Tuesdays or whatever Thursday," and he gives you the spiel. So, and my friends are like, "You didn't know who Yeehaw?" I felt like I had done something bad by not knowing who you were. This is a couple years ago.
Nobody has more fun than us. We have the most fun of all.
I do.
Good.
Now, so 17 years at Walt Disney World. Hold on, I'm looking at my questions here.
Yeah. What's first one?
What I noticed was the adults got into it just as much as the kids.
Well, I hope so.
Did you plan that, or was it started off as a kid's thing?
I just love to entertain. I love to draw people in. I love to throw it out there and reel them in. And I just, it's more fun than you can possibly imagine.
Well, it absolutely works. I mean, when the adults started to get involved, did you think, oh, this is weird, or you expected it?
Well, no, I know what I'm doing. You know, you have to plan, you have to think about. You know, I've been involved in sing-along for a long, long time, and there's definitely a way to get people to go.
Growing up, who were some of your idols? Like a Soupy Sales or something?
Jimmy Durante, Fats Waller.
Okay.
Mitch Miller.
Okay, I saw a black and white video of you where I think you called, it said something, it wasn't Yeehaw Bob, which is who we know you as now.
Oh, yeah.
Yazoo?
Yazoo, yep.
Was it, oh, it was pronounced Yazoo?
Or Jazoo, Jazoo.
Jazoo.
Yeah, my wife and I had a little nostalgia duo. We and I had a little pencil-thin mustache, and I would drive a 1955 Fleetwood Cadillac, and we just sang all these old songs. It was really great. I loved to play the old boogie-woogie, the old stride piano.
That's what I was gonna ask you about. Can I show that black and white quick video of you on the piano?
Of course, of course. The St. Louis Blues Boogie Woogie.
And I heard that a guy who works for Pixar, somebody might know his name, John Lasseter.
Yeah, John.
He comes and comes to Port Orleans to see you.
Mm-hmm. He's coming in a couple weeks. And he's a great guy. You know, what a wonderful, interesting life he's led.
Was it true the first few times you didn't know that he was there in the audience?
Yeah, it's true. I had no idea. I didn't know who he was. And as just as well, because I had him running around the room and rolling on the floor. And
you had me doing the hokey-pokey and things
good.
I haven't done since I was, you
right
know, a
in,
kid.
Right foot out, left foot in, shake it all around. Oh, yeah! Oh! Ah, what's the next question? So, question.
They're actually not questions as much as like, my, hold on, let's see, what do I got it?
Nah, okay. Nah.
2013 Legacy Award.
Right.
What's that?
Well, you know, I'd go in there and I would do that show the same way with a reward, no award. All I want to do is go in there and do my very, very best show.
But let's take some credit. Come on. What is that award, first of all? Let's say you didn't win it. Somebody else won it. What is that award?
It's a peer recognition award that I won.
So people
it's fantastic.
Other cast members
voted for me, yeah.
That's got to feel good, no matter what. That shows that you're being recognized for the entertainment that you're doing.
I love to entertain.
See, me being an entertainer, different than you, I admire your craft completely and how, to me, you're a legend that's still alive, and I'm glad we have you for a long time still.
I ain't going anywhere.
Tell me what goes on at the House of Blues, please, because I know you do something else there. With a partner, I think.
I do lots of different things. Just before I came here to do this interview with you, I was performing at an assisted living facility. I love putting on these old senior shows. I perform down at Give Kids a World once a month. I put on children's shows. This summer I put on a children's show at all 20 public libraries in Orange County, Osceola County. I love just to entertain. When I'm at the House of Blues, it's a little different. We get to play some little different music and
different costume for House of Blues. Different
different
feeling?
Stuff, different feeling. Yeah.
More adult than what you do at Port Orleans, I'm sure.
Yeah. But I love to play and I love to entertain, and it's whatever we got to do, we're going to get it done.
Now, Give Kids the World, you do more than just entertaining, don't you? You travel sometimes to do things for Give Kids.
Going up to Geneseo for our good friend Dr. Dave Parfit. We'll all be up there at Geneseo, New York, on October the 4th.
I have a ceiling fan and I'm so scared. He's very tall. And I'm so
ceiling
scared he's going to like jump
ceiling
and
fan.
Hit it.
Oh.
I don't know if
the strobe light.
I'll make sure the effect is picked up.
All right.
So Give Kids the World, you're big with Give Kids the World.
I love that.
I have to tell you, I have a personal thing with Give Kids the World because of a cousin when I was 19 who did finally pass away of leukemia, but Give Kids the World was amazing. And what they did for the family out in the, I forget the name of the village over here, the Give Kids the World village was fantastic. So
it's a nice place.
I applaud you for that. You have CDs that are available?
Man.
Wait, no, when I spoke to you last, you were making CDs, but you also had older ones. These are new ones you're working
on? Yeah, I've got seven, eight. I don't know, John, I've lost track. But right now I'm working on two new CDs, on an original piano CD and on a Disney CD. And the Disney CD I'm really excited about because I get to use all my different character voices and it's really lots
what
of fun.
What voices do you do?
Oh, well, you'll have to play one for him, yeah.
Because I try Mickey Mouse. That's the only one I think I can do
sometimes.
Well,
you could play... CD. I brought the CD here tonight.
All right, we're going to listen to some of them while
we're... Good, good. I'll leave it here with you.
Awesome.
And you can play the Let's Go Fly a Kite. It's really the best. But they're all good.
Okay. Now, what's available now? And where can I buy it?
Online at my website, yeehawbob.com. I've got the live show. I've got all my old ragtime boogie woogie. I've got a children's CD, a gospel piano CD. I've got two original pianos music CDs.
I would love to hear the ragtime stuff. I got to go check that out.
Oh, yeah. I used to, that's all I used to play because I'm left-handed. And I used to take lessons from a man by the name of Dick Hyman. And Dick was very famous at that 1930s style. And he was a great mentor to me. So
Dick
Hyman. Yeah, Dick.
No longer with us.
H-Y-M-A-N, Dick Hyman.
No longer with us in here?
What's that?
Passed away?
No, I think he's still alive. Lives down in Venice, Florida.
Ah, does he know what you're doing now?
I don't...
That'd be a nice reunion.
Yeah, he does. He knows what I'm doing. He knows what I'm doing.
What is the future hold for you, except for the CDs? What do you just see the future? I mean, you obviously love what you're doing, so I don't expect you to change too much.
Well, I plan on staying there at Port Orleans. I'd love to get involved in a children's TV show. I love composing. I love travel and writing and getting out and putting on these shows. And I just love to go.
Jesus, you are so entertaining and so fun to watch just here. This is the one interview that I'm actually not going to have to edit.
Oh!
From start to finish.
Frightening.
You will not get one cut in this interview.
Oh! Okay. Whatever. No. This is good. I love all this stuff.
Wait, you're saying I love all this stuff. I could put something you don't like there.
Ah.
Do you like, what flavor don't you like?
I don't know. Anything you want to do.
Because I could put chocolate if you don't like chocolate.
Anything you want to do.
All right, I'm going to put some videos and pictures up there. And you've covered everything I want. What else? Right. What's the future hold for Yeehaw Bob?
I want to invite all my friends, of course, to come out to Port Orleans. We're there Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And come right, sit right up front, make all the noise that you can. I want to give a big shout out to all my friends watching the Big Fat Panda Show. Be sure and pay a good close attention to John. He's
Thank
a good
sir.
Man. And we love you guys.
I can't wait to see how the horn. I can't wait to see the horn.
Woo!
It's infectious.
Okay, we did good, John.
Thank you very much, sir.
That's my pleasure.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's Yeehaw Bob. Thank you. He's really a great guy. Some interview, huh? And there you have it, show number 16. Our guest next month is Michelle from the Main Street Mouse, followed the next month by Keith Lapinig. If you, a family member or a loved one, are planning a trip to Walt Disney World, take a look at dvcrentals.com. There's no secrets. Everything is there on the website, price calculator. If you have questions, call the number there. I just can't tell you how much you can save over regular reservations and be in a luxury villa or studio. Just take a look, please, and let me know what you think if you do. And get ready for Christmas. Next month starts my Christmas coverage, and I am so excited. It is my favorite time of the year. So go forth, create pandemonium, and above all, please give out those big panda hugs. I've been receiving them from you guys in the parks. Keep them coming. I'm not as startled as I was. I just get hugs, and I'm accepting them and loving them. Recharges the soul. Until next time, Panda out.
It's jelly. It's jelly.